Well, from Wall Street to Main Street, News 8's Project Economy is our commitment to coverage beyond the headlines. And this morning, the first of four cruise ships this week in the process of docking right now at the Ocean Gateway Terminal.
Beautiful weather for it. While we know that a big business, while it's part of a big business tourism here in the state of Maine, this particular ship could really help the local economy even more. And here to tell us why is News 8's Dave Guthro in the studio with the preview. Hey, Dave.
Hey, how you doing, Aaron? Good morning to you and good morning to Shannon. Yeah, good news here. Remember a few weeks ago we told you that Congresswoman Shelley Pingree sent a letter to several different companies, cruise ship companies, asking them to buy lobsters while their ships were docked in Portland. Well, it turns out that two of them actually took them up on that. One of them, Celebrity Cruise Lines, owns Celebrity Summit, and as you said, set to arrive here later this morning, perhaps in the next half hour. Now, the cruise line has agreed to purchase 3,800 pounds of lobster from Ready Seafood on Commercial Street. Now, while lobster biologists say the catch is starting to decrease, a glut on the market brought down the price of soft-shell lobsters all summer long. So Pingree asked cruise ship companies to buy up lobsters in order to help local fishermen. Now, overall, of course, cruise ships bring big business to Maine. A University of Maine study found that in 2008, more than 48,000 passengers generated between $5.8 and $8 million. Now, when this season is over, there will have been more than 63,000 cruise ship passengers in Portland. Those visitors are projected to spend around $6 million while here. And again, the Celebrity Summit is set to dock here in Portland in about 30 minutes. The ship will bring over 5,000 passengers to the Old Port before she continues on to Bar Harbor. Hopefully they spend a little money while they're here in Portland. Live in the studio, Dave Guthro, News 8.